Hey, Galena, you're waiting for me. Just setting things up here. Hey, Shauna. Your setup was really good yesterday, Shauna. Your lighting and everything, it was awesome. Just trying to get my focus in right. Oh. Hey, Linda. Kia. Put this over here. I guess I should pan out a tiny bit. Oh, that's so weird. Sometimes Logitech goes in little steps for zooming in and out. Sometimes it doesn't. It's weird. Let's see. I just did one. It will only do one, which is strange. Very strange. Now it's all wonky. I don't know why, but it does. Hey, Janet, Linda, Kim. Oh, I guess that'll have to do. So did you guys all get your papers ready? It's gonna be fun. Picture and lighting are good. Okay. You should see my setup, Shauna, if you think yours is bad. My camera sits on a, oh yeah, I'll take a picture and show you. Take a picture of my camera and my can you see it? I have a fan and I have lights clipped to my fan. Plus my fan has lights. And then this, wait a minute. This is an easel. that my camera is hooked to the end of it. So, yeah, I know all about trying to find a way of getting more light. ACB. But it's not in the way, which is good, because it's all hanging. And I can move the easel, the little table easel, up and down and back and forth sideways. And it doesn't really jiggle. So, yeah, you find ways. If there's a will, there's a way. Yeah, it's hard to. This table's not bad because it's pretty sturdy. So whenever I move, it doesn't necessarily move a lot. My other table I had at home was a marble based table with a glass top. It was an old table, and it was great because it was so darn heavy, nothing would move. But I've got that out on my deck right now as my patio table. So, but this one's pretty good. But I would like a bigger surface. That's pretty bad. My surface right now is about 5 by 4, 5 foot by 4 foot. But I still need more room. Yeah, it's just finding a way of configuring it, Shauna. Getting some kind of, I don't know, something that you can, like an L frame of some sort. Even if you could find, you know, those clothes racks, if you could put a clothes rack so the sides go on your desk, if you don't mind screwing into the desk, and then you can have a track on the top. That would work. Is it Chai's Craft? Welcome. I don't think I've seen you here. It's all about de-stressing here. Having a good time. No, I don't like to talk about bad things that are going on in the world. This is a place just to forget all of that and enjoy. Yeah, either boom arm or I was thinking a shower rod across. Yeah, that would work. Yeah, there's a will. Shy. Okay. Awesome. Welcome. It's a good group here. I don't know if you've been here before or not, but we're pretty drama-free here. That's right, Kia. Hey, Button. You've lurked? Well, I'm glad you felt good enough to come and chat. It's a good group here. Hey, Monique. Oh, you're going to get something, Shauna? Hey, Colleen. Are you going to art along? I think it's going to be fun. Hey, Kim. Linda. I'll just wait a couple more minutes and then we'll start talking about what we're going to do. You haven't decided yet? It's going to be messy. Eileen should be here shortly. She likes messy. Oh, I didn't mean that, Shy. I was just stating that we like to just art here and support each other. No, you're welcome here. Oh, good, Linda. Awesome. There she is. Morning, Eileen. Are you feeling better? Hey, Scoops. Yeah, Janet. Speak of the devil. Her ears must have been burning. Oh, good. Awesome. So everybody's gonna be playing along, or some are just gonna lay back and watch me make a mess. This will be fun. It's different. I've done a lot of mosaics in my lifetime being a stained glass artist, but so I figure this is going to be very similar, but a little easier and less time to do it, of course. Yes, I know, Eileen, you love watching other people mess up, make a mess of their art room. So what I've done so far is this is just the Diane Reevely book, and I'm going to do it in this for today. My camera's just a little bit crooked, so let me fix this. Crooked drives me nuts when things are crooked. There, that's better. And so what I've done is I've taken a page and I gessoed it. I put two coats on and dried it. The painting I'm working on is abstract and kind of like what you were. Oh, awesome, Kia. Yeah, you don't have to do an apple like this one here. If you've got a pear or something else you want to do, go ahead. It's basically the same process. No, I just used a basic, it's fairly smooth. I think it was Liquitex, white gesso, just your regular gesso. You can use heavy gesso if you want, but you don't really want texture yet. because you're going to have to be gluing down papers. So you don't want to have to be gluing down onto texture, because then you get air bubbles. So whoever has the book, I'm pretty sure you probably all read this section to find out what we're going to do. So in this book, I'll put it up so it's not layered. She's given you two ways of going about doing the drawing and the painting, basically. So you can find an image of an apple and glue it onto your board if you want, and just use that as your base coat. What I'm going to use is my Liquitex matte medium. So if you don't want to do it this way, then you can always get a reference from wherever and draw your own apple, just so that's a little easier for everyone that haven't got a book. I will be using this reference that she did. So it's going to have all the greens and kind of orangey golds, that type of thing, white, a little bit of purple, mauve. So find your image to start, or if you haven't gesso, whatever substrate you're going to be using. You can be using paper too. I wouldn't get a very thin paper. You want something a little bit thicker, because you're going to be putting a lot of wet material down. So this is just like a manila, almost like a file folder. You could even use a file folder if you wanted to. And then just put a couple coats of matte medium down so that it seals it, won't go right through then. And it gives your glue a little something to stick to, adhere to. Apple juice. I doubt that. You're a good artist. I've seen your stuff. Okay, Linda. Awesome. Follow along me if you don't have a... It's matte medium, CB. I'll be gluing with matte medium, but I gessoed it first, the substrate. Hey, Wendy. I'm not a fan of stinking red ore. I was having a hard time with that. Well, you don't have to do red. Do whatever color. It's going to be the same process, Kim. So it doesn't really matter what color. You can pick your favorite color for the background. Hey, Lori. Hey, Debbie. You got so much snow last night. Oh, yeah, we got snow last night too. It's really cold out today, but I'm hoping it's dying down. I got to get back to work. It's been 3 weeks. I got to be able to drive. I've got a 3.5, almost 4 hour drive to where I get my stuff, and then 4 hours back. So It's got to be good weather on the highways to travel that. So I'm hoping. You want snow? You must be in a hot area. You can have all my snow. I have about a 5-foot drift in my backyard. Oh, Eileen. I'm so low to feel that. Oh. No, they can't, because I make the product, bring the product to them. And then when I get the product to them, I restock my supplies and bring it back. I only go like every 2 weeks. So it's, you know, it's not that bad. But yes, I am near the lake. I'm near, Kia, do you know where Port Elgin is? I'm about 12 minutes away from there, inland, in Paisley. Yeah, it's a drive, but it gives me a chance to go visit, because I'll stop into Cambridge, go visit my sister, and then where I get my supplies, that's where my two brothers live. So I go visit them, and then I come back. So it gives me a way of visiting, keeping in touch with everyone. I don't think we are going to get any this year. Where are you, Wendy? I didn't see that. I'm on the coast. Oh, okay. So the warmer area. Oh, Virginia Beach. Oh, nice. Hubby works in Detroit through the week. Home each weekend, so I get that drive. Yeah, Button. I'm sick of snow and ice. In 1976. Did you like it, Eileen? Did you like the snow? Oh, it wouldn't surprise me anymore where it snows, because they got snow in the desert, for Pete's sakes, in somewhere in Arabian desert somewhere. I can't remember where it was. And now they're getting flooding of all things. Like, it's weird. And my dog loved it. Yeah, I bet. All right, so people who are arting along, get your gesso down, dry it, and then decide what you want to do. If you want to use a photo, you can use a photo, or you can draw it. It doesn't have to be precise in detail, because we're going to putting the paper on top. We're only looking for your colors and tones and shading, highlights. So just make sure you have those where you want them, because that's where we're going to be. It's kind of like a map, that we're going to make a map by the underpainting. Oh yeah, Kathy Bragg was supposed to be here. Hey, Mitz. She might be just lurking. I'm not sure. So I'm going to draw. I'm going to put this. Well, I'll put this up. I'll put something so it's Okay. I'll put something up so it don't get a glare for you guys. Let's see. Needs to be a little taller. Still can't get used to the left and right of this. Okay, so whoever needs this drawing, you can draw it. It's pretty basic. And I will draw on this side. Doesn't matter what you use because it'll be covered with paper anyways. So don't worry about drawing I'm going to make mine fairly big so you guys can see. Ooh, kind of wonky. Here's my wonky. And then I'm just going to put some lines in for the tablecloth. And the background. And one down here. I'm not going to be, you know, precise about this. I think there's a kind of a wrinkle in here that you might want to. If there's a wrinkle, see, I'm getting kind of anal. Then it won't be a straight line. I think that's what they were trying to do here. So let's do a little bit of a, and then up here is just a background, basically. Hey, Pacola. That is so weird. I still can't sub anybody. That is so weird. I don't know why. Can't even pop out chat. It's weird. Oh, well, as long as I can see you guys talking. Just give it a go. Doesn't have to be fancy. So we got a shadow here from the and we'll probably have a shadow from this leaf. She didn't put one in, so maybe I won't either. But we have a stem. We want veins. She's actually put veins in. So let's do that. The stem has a highlight, mostly on the top here. And then the shadow is, the biggest one is going to be down here and along the side. And then it slowly fades off to lighter and lighter and lighter. Right here is going to be a highlight and a little bit of a highlight up here. Hi, Anne. Okay, so is everybody drawing? So let me know when you're done. And I get my brushes ready. Let's see. Brushes don't have to be fancy. Don't use watercolor brushes, but something that's you can work with. I like working with a flat. I think these are old plaid. I've had them for like over 10 years. From decorative painting or toll painting or one stroke. So I kept the paint that I had out yesterday. So let's see. Avocado, I have light green, citron green, and I think I had a yellow one out. Yep, there it is. And then there's opaque yellow. And if you want to lighten something, just use a bit of white, because we want this fairly opaque. She showed a bird. Underpainted stage on an old ledger page. She was starting last night on Facebook. So cute. Oh, who is that, Debbie? Who are you talking about? I missed something. You talking about the artist, Elizabeth St. Hilary? Oh, cool. I love her stuff. And I know she does all kinds of retreats. Okay, so is everybody up to the drawing? They're done? And have you got your paints ready? Now, we're not going to use a whole lot of water in this. We don't need to. Oh, yeah, and red. I did find some of these. Paprika, the Americana multi-surface satin paint. I haven't even opened it, so I'm going to try some of this for the background. Linda's ready. So let's start with the background first. For painting in. Gotta shake that more. They are thinner and dry, shiny. Oh, really? Well, maybe I won't use it then. Thanks for letting me know that. I'll try these then. Okay, I'm just going to use the Americana Cherry Red and Cadmium Red. Maybe some yellow. Okay, so I'll open the book, see. Actually, what did she do? She actually painted her apple. She painted everything green. So let's paint the background a really light citron green, and then we'll paint over top of it. The apple, we're not going to paint everything green. Okay, I'm going to have to move this. So, see, she gets the color of the green showing through the orange is what she did there. So if you want to do that, you can. I don't think it's really necessary. Just play with the background, get some different shading of your whatever color you're going to pick. You don't have to do the orange. And then whatever papers you have that you're going to do in the background, make sure you're using paint similar to it, or you're going to have a tough, you might have to make more paper. I did the apple first, so I will work on background. Okay. I have a bunch of reddish colors, orangey, yellowy for the background. So I'm just going to put something in there. Stuck. That's weird. I need a pokey tool. I'll just pour it out. Pour some out. Yellow. Okay. Brush go. You don't want to add a lot of water to this, because and just mishmash. You're going to make a mixed media colorful background. So whatever color you've picked in your papers for the background, use your paint. Because this is what I will refer to when I start doing my papers. You don't want too much green because then you're going to get too similar a color with your apple. If your apple's going to be green, different shades of green. So I would stick with something that's going to be a bit darker than your apple. You go in with a little bit of very dark red or even some dark green. I think I'll put some yellow up here. Maybe some down here. I think I need some darker red. A little bit of dark. Let's put some Napthol crimson in. Where's this cherry red? Yeah, maybe cherry red. I think I used that in my papers. Just a bit. Just to give it a bit of depth. Here. Thanks, Eileen. All right. Next, let's paint our apple. Our apple is the green. So whatever greens you've decided to use for your papers, we will paint your apple in. So I'm starting with the lightest color, which is the citron green. A bit of so I'm going to paint. There's a booger. Not worried if I have a little something else in there. Apples. If you look at an apple, you'll see that there is almost a pattern to their skin. It kind of goes down. So if you can paint in the direction of the apple, that will help you when it comes to doing your collage. And then I need some avocado color. Booger's add texture. I'm going to mix some of the avocado green. So this is the shadowed area right here. This is an old brush. It hasn't got a fine point on it anymore. And then as I go up, I'm going to add a little bit of the citron green. Paper towels. Okay. Just kind of blend it in. Doesn't have to be great. I'm going to add a little bit of evergreen. It's even darker for the very, very edge here. It needs to be a little bit darker. If you want to add a little bit of black to your green, that'll darken it too, but just a pinch, not too much. Just to suggest where the darkest areas are. This is the darkest area there. There's more green up in here by the leaf. I missed, I think. Let's see. Yeah. That's the stem. I need a pointier brush. Something with an edge to it. That a little bit. Oh, it's part of the leaf. That's what it is. See, I'm already confused. That's the highlight. That's a highlight. This here's part. And here. The leaf. Will be darker in certain areas. Again, I'm painting in the direction that the leaf would be growing. And that'll give me an idea on paper how to tear it. I kind of want to, I still want to see where the veins are, because what I'm going to do is I'm going to tear the paper in the sections where the veins are. Like so. Just want to make this a little bit more gradual. Then I'm just putting a little light area right in the side of the apple here, because you will get a little bit of a light that's reflected off of the tablecloth. This, I'll show you. So you can paint this kind of a yellowish color and then put some white over top of it. It won't be white per se. Hey, Jilly. Anyone that came in I didn't say hi to, hi. Hope you're gonna play along with us. It'll just give you, doesn't have to be perfect. It'll give you an idea where that highlight was. I'll put a little bit more yellow in here. There's the stem. Then we need to do the stem, and it'll be sienna color and browns, light brown, that type of thing. So I'm going to put some, this is burnt sienna. I'm just going to put a base coat in. You're welcome, Scoops. And then a little bit darker. Where did I put that? I'll just add a little bit of black to it. Just to darken it. So. So on the and then some really light stuff for the very top. And I think I need a little bit of white right here. Okay. And I think I'm going to make the ribs in the leaf. Just so I know where they are. The veining. There we go. And I think I want this side to be the darker shaded side. And the other side to be the highlighted side of the leaf. So it won't have any white on it, but it will be very, very pale. So that'll give me an idea of the shades of green I need to put there. I needed, there's a shadowed area here of purple. So put some purple in. And I think a little bit of dioxazine purple, just a smidgen. Not much. Bit of white. A little bit more purple. Maybe even, no, I don't think I'll put black in. And whiten that up a bit. There. All right. Now we can do the lines also just to basically let you know where the lines are going to be, because we will end up covering them. She did it a different way. She painted it all green and then put white in. You don't have to really put a specific color in unless you want to. She's kind of got all different shades of the background in and the apple. So she's mixed things up. I think I'm just going to do blue and green right now, just so I know where I want the lines and how thick I want the lines. Maybe a little red. I'm going to bring this down. A little bit more level. I think I'll put another one in here. in here, and here, maybe another one there. All right. Hey, Wendy, Marie. Okay, so that's it for that part. So how's everyone coming along with theirs? Doing lines, okay? Mine's wet, but good. Yep, mine's wet too. So take your hair dryer, heat gun, whatever you have, or wave the paper around and dry it.
Okay, Wendy. Happy shopping. Try and get your stuff like really dry because you're going to be putting a lot of matte medium on and it's going to be pretty wet. Oh, Wendy, I love Holbein. Do you have to buy the set or do they have individual? Yeah, paints or pencils. I love the pencils. I haven't tried any of the paints.
About the set pencils only, roughly 2,400 yen. Oh, yeah, I've got the set. I was hoping to find somewhere that I can buy individual. Because I would love to get some of those, what is it called? They have two whites. One's harder than the other. I think it's called soft white. It's excellent for going over anything, even your pencil. But I can't find anybody that sells it and ships to Canada. So is everyone up to par with me? Done drying? Where are you, Colleen? I'm going to get my papers ready, and that'll give you a bit of time. Kathy, didn't know you were a Canuck, too. Oh, didn't you? Yeah, I'm a Canuck, Ontario. Jillie, where are you? In North? Well, thanks, Kia. Oh, cool. Yeah, it's pretty cold there. Haven't been there. Yeah, we're neighbors. Kind of. Okay. You're almost there. Have you got the book, Colleen? The first thing we're going to be playing with is the background. Now, what she says is that you need to work from the back to the front in this process. Ah, really? Rats. You have to put it back on your list. Okay. I don't need these. Oh, you're probably needing this to look at. So I want all my oranges and reds, gold colors to do this part. So I'm just looking through my stuff here. That's one. I did a bunch of these yesterday. That'll be a good one. That would probably work good. So you want different shades of this color background. So it gives it a more interesting look.
And if you can, find some with different patterns in it. You can also
do you see me yet? Or are you still buffering? Okay. All right. So this seems to be one of my darkest colors. And this one, kind of the same. It's got a little bit of darker color in there. And I could go into that too. Then that could be lighter. I think I want a little bit of yellow in it. So the real dark areas, what we're going to do is the way she's done hers. Let's see. Okay, so work from back to front. Begin to glue down your paper pieces. Remember to work in small areas and work back to front in your composition. Apply gel medium to the panel or lay down your torn pieces of paper into the glue. Brush the second layer of glue over the papers. Press papers firmly with the glue brush to eliminate bubbles and prevent buckling. So small pieces. See, she's got all kinds of different colors and patterns. So that's what we're going to do. Any questions? So we're going to start off and tear. Best to tear your pieces. And I don't want to use any white yet. And because there's really no directional look to the background, you can just do whatever. So I want fairly dark pieces in the background. So I'm going to find the darkest areas and just going to piece them down right now. And I want to have a variety also of patterns. So take a few different pieces. I guess I could use this on the edge here. Use your edges where you have edges, and you can overlap. What are you using for glue? I'm using matte medium. So I'm just going to put a bunch out on a palette. Get a glue brush that you're not too scared to have glue sitting in it. So I'm going to just use this one. So I don't think I have my other one out. Nah, that's too big. I have another one, but it's too big. So you can audition your papers if you want before you glue down. I'm kind of anal that way. There's a bit of yellow in here. So I'm going to use the yellow. So you just think I could use it up there. So you just, you can glue the area and then just put some more glue on the back here and stick her down. And then glue on top. And just keep doing that. And they can overlap. And if you got a credit card or I got one there. Something you can use. I got my old driver's license. Dark area. Or you can just dip it in the glue if you want. This one here. And it depends how you tear your paper, because if you tear a certain way, you'll get the white line. So see how I'm tearing towards me? If I tear away from me, that side doesn't have the white. Depends if you want the white. Maybe you do. Go down, then go back and squish it down. I think that could go there. And the dark piece. So if you feel like you have to audition stuff, go ahead and do it. This can take as long as you want. You can just do a bit. Like, it's not something you have to finish completely, which is nice. You do want to cover all your painted surface. I suppose you could leave some of it not covered because you've painted it. So that over there. Maybe as you're doing this, you've decided to make it a little bit different. This is, go ahead and change it up. Take this. And I can get in there with a point. So something smoother. Don't want any white. I think I missed that. Well, maybe not. Let's see. So you don't have to worry about getting your glue on your painting, because it's going to have to be glued anyways. So that's the nice thing about this. You don't have to be careful. Let's do some over here. And a dark piece. That'll fit there. Don't want that edge. There. Oop. Fingers are getting sticky. That's the only thing. Gotta wipe your fingers off or you glue yourself together. Hey, how's everyone doing? It all working out for everybody? Use the corner. kind of got off course, but it's getting better. That's okay. Do you need me to stop a bit, or are you gluing yet? Yeah, wood pecola. It would be awesome. You never know. I might do some. Got to get some art for my house. Let's see. I kind of know what I'm going to do for my dining room. But I just got to find the time. That's the thing for me. It's the time to do stuff. Put my green there. Let's see. I'm good. Yes. Okay. Well, there's no rush. You know what to do. Just keep gluing your background. It's supposed to be fun. Don't get all stressed out, then it's not fun anymore. So if you're stressing out, go and have a coffee. Sit and relax and watch. And then you can always come back to it. Okay, I want to be around that piece of the stem. That'll work. Little piddly pieces around the stem here. Could go like that, maybe. Piece in there. And a piece there, what I want. Maybe some greenish color. I think this is too similar up here, so I'm going to stick something else on there. Break that up. There. And a smidgen up down there. Right here. Okay. There. Okay, that's the background. So after you're done the background, give it a drying. My drying. Oh, awesome. Colleen. You're flying.
Oh, hi, Kathy. Yep, we're just doing the background. I think it's awesome. It's relaxing. Anyone can do this. That's great, Kathy.
It's not completely dry, but we're not going to be working on that area anymore. So it doesn't have to be completely dry, just dry enough so that you can work over it. Let's see, what does it say now? Okay, now it says to apply strips to these areas. Let's see, wait a minute. It's 12. Next, let's collage in the strips. You will need to tear thin strips of paper. Don't be tempted to cut your paper with scissors. To fit the composition, feel free to let the papers run off the edges of the panel. We will come back later and trim them after they've dried. Okay, so we do the strips. So you can use, looks like it's just all the colors that they're going to be using in the apple in the background. So we can do that. So just as thin as possible. They don't have to be exact. Drawing the painted background. I did the apple first. That's fine. So I'm just going to tear out a bunch and then lay them down. Decide where I want them. So audition them. Some of them are a little bit curved, which will give the tablecloth a little bit of of a different dimension. Let me go put that one there. Green, maybe. Let's see what I got. I'm gonna do some of this color. Different. So I'm just tearing. They can be, try to get them a little bit similar in size, width. You can always cut them down a little bit more if they're thick. A lot of people like doing mosaics and this type of piecework. Just, it's relaxing. Let's see. Could probably, maybe I'll do this one on here. This one here. That on the end. And green. Let's see. I guess I like this because it reminds me of my days of mosaics. I haven't done that in years. Okay, that's too straight. We can put that one there. I need a real yellow one. Yellow. Okay, like that. And more. There. Maybe that one there. Another green. Green one there. Okay, let's start laying some of these down. Let's see. Okay, I think I'm going to put this one here. And this one, I think I'm going to put here. Turn it. Over. I'm going to go over them. I'm not going to piece it. I'm going to go over them. So I think that will look cool. Shoe. Make this thinner. Like so. And then this one, I'm going to have go like that. Like so. Scrape them down so they lay flat. Actually, that should be, oh, I'll piece that one. Green. To under over like that. Kind of basket weaving. Yes, I'm weird that way. Kathy, is Theory white covered with paper too? With this? Yes, it's covered with any kind of text paper. Different sizes, numbers, so you'll have to cut out squares. actually, that should be cut back just a smidge. There. Green strips. Oh, good. You're just sticking along with me. You're doing good. The knot theory. Don't know why my table does that. Tablet. I don't get you, Kia. Why didn't we put down? Well, I'm just going to the way the book. I actually thought of that. Why didn't we just put it down? It would have been easier, but I'm just following along the directions she put. Hey, Kathy. But these are the things you find out. Yeah. Makes sense. I would have done that, but maybe she's got a theory behind it. I don't know. Spelling errors. Oh, okay. So over, under, under, over. That would have been under. New. That one up. That one. Let's see, under, over. So put that one down first. I'm running out of papers. So what do I want there? Like that. Wouldn't want to put it over. Okay. You don't have to do this. I'm just weird. Hey, Joycey. Coffee alert. I can put one of these over here. pack. A piece of here. I done. I can see why you wouldn't want to do a real small, you know, a little tiny piece of art, because that would be a bit of a pain trying to cut all that. I guess I should have one there. Hey, cat. This one, I should have a longer one. Try this one. A little bit skinnier. Making this a little thinner so it wouldn't be as big and bulky. In the background, that's it. You got glue on my fingers. How's everyone doing? Are you multitasking, Deb? Getting ready for your stream too? Gluing away. Good. I'm going to just dry this. good idea, Deb. Yeah, so anyone that's doing this, painting along, use the hashtag FibPaintAlong. And then everyone can see what everyone did on Instagram or Twitter, Facebook. I'm just going to cut these. No, I want to. No, I went to post office. Oh. Looking good. Like. All right, let's see what, now we have to do the white. So it says, collage the white to the tablecloth using bits of white paper. White in its many shades and variations, of course. That contains text and type. The papers you use here may include pages from old books, sheet music, old letters, or documents. And handwritten lists and notes. Make sure you have a plenty variety of the type of paper and in the density of type text. It says, after you finish the collaging in your whites, you'll want to fill in your shadow areas with bits of violet paper in a variety of light and medium values. So, find your whatever book. Get mine out. Grab newspaper. Tissue paper, books, magazines, whatever. Music. This and we need an old book. Some sort. Let's see. All right, got a collection. So same thing, you tear the shape you want and glue her on. So I don't think it matters, you know, what size print goes where. So let's find some. This is an old stained glass art. Thing. So I got some really small prints here. And here's some different ones. Gardening magazine. Here's a good one. Newspaper. Oh, crossword puzzles. Well, these will be cool. Awesome. Those. Tissue paper of music. More tissue paper. Large letters. Just take a bunch of that. That should do me. You have to go outside, Chloe. I have to take Chloe outside. So while you guys are catching up, find your different types of text and numbers and different papers, and I'll be right back. Okay, come on.
Okay, I'm back.
You have to take one out, you have to take the other. I low-key heard your dog barking on video. Back and looking around. That's funny, Shauna. Thanks, Mitz. All right, so now we can take pieces of our different types of text and place them somewhere. Shoo. And again, it's the same thing. You don't want straight lines. So I'm going to fold and then tear along the fold to get the angle. Otherwise, that's going to be crazy. So there. So it's still, you know, it's still jagged, but at least you got a chance of getting it similar to the shape you're trying to put it in. And you don't have to worry about, oh, I did that one and I can't do that one. Silly, silly girl. So I'll use it on here. So, because you got white, so if you don't get it exact, it's okay. Start gluing again. Is that the right way or is it this way? No, maybe. How did I do that? Well, it must have been that way. Good enough. Use this little piece in here. Just tear some of that off. Stick it in there. Everyone doing all right? So, let's see. This one. And then like that. But here I was doing it. Yeah. And this one. Hold it. Easier if you fold them, guys, and then tear it with your fingers and try to eye it. There. Thank you. still a little bit off. So I don't want to cover all of my stripes. It would have been a whole lot easier, like CB said, to do this first and then put the stripes on. Definitely. But like I said, I was just following the directions. Well, this will be easy. With tissue, you can just tear it. Or you could do into little small bits of pieces, I guess. That looks cool. Maybe some notes paper. Some music notes. I gotta put in more. Let's see. Do that. That'll work. Yeah, the tissue paper is easier because then you don't see where the end is. So if you go over top of it a bit, it's not going to matter a whole lot. Let's do some more text. There. Let's try this one up here, maybe. Thank you. All right. And then I think I need a little piece on there, right here, a smidge. Over there, getting in the zone here. Can always tell when I'm quiet. Too much. There. Getting there. Let's put some more over here. Let's see. Papers all over the place. Right. These lines of words are cool. Now you can put them there. Think. Cut that one a little bit. That, maybe one here. Kind of piddly work, but it's cool. I like it. The newspaper's kind of cool too, because if there's any color print on the other side, it just slightly peeks through, and that kind of gives it a different look. Just some ordinary print. And you could have the print going a certain direction if you wanted to. Because that wood enhance the look, definitely. So it's all a learning process of doing more and figuring more out. You may like certain things and you may not like certain things. It's all playing with stuff, seeing what you like. For me, I think if like this tablecloth, for instance, in reality, it would have straight lines. So if I were to do this again, I think I would actually cut them myself, because they are straight. Right, and a little smidgen over here. Get it off my finger. Where else? I think I need some more over there. Just to cover this white up. And maybe right in here. That. I don't like the blue on there. There. And then any of the, I think I need a little bit there. Then any of the white here has to be done with your papers you painted that were mauve. Okay, let me check chat to make sure everyone's okay. I like gluing. You like it too, you call me. Good. And maybe this will be one of your things you like to do. That would be awesome. I know I painted some of these. Let's see where they are. Gotta find my purples or molds. Julie, glue and paint together are pretty awesome. They are. Artistic meets scrapbooking meets paper piecing.
Yeah, that's pretty well what we're doing. Okay, so we can play. I wonder how difficult this stuff is going to be. So I got different shades of so I can actually use this. Like that. Okay, how was I doing that again? That. No, it's this way. Like. Like that. So I just fold along the lines I have to do. Okay, so my darkest shadow area is close to the bottom of the apple. But see how I paint it? Now this is when you're going to have to pay attention to stuff. So I have a lighter area right here. So I've picked a piece of paper with a light area on the corner. Oh, cool, Dot. So this is when you have to pay attention to your shadow areas, color changes, and that type of thing. So I have a darker area again, and then goes to a light area. Now you can piece probably on top of each other. So you don't have a piece of paper that has all those things, then just piece it in smaller pieces. So now I gotta get a lighter area. It'd be like this is lighter. So I'd have to come into there. No. Just take a little bit off of there and should be good.
And if a little of the background shows through, I wouldn't worry about it because it's the color you're playing with. Okay, now I'm into the lighter shades. Let's see. I should take some. It's a little bit too wide. There we go. And this little piece, I think, could go in here. Real light one. That could be lighter. Let's try this stuff. Yeah, that might work. Alrighty. Yeah, your tissue paper or deli wraps are awesome for this because you can see through it a little bit easier for tearing. Mine is looking very, very Kimberly. What's that? You gonna post it? I wanna see. That's true, Debbie. Let's see. I think I want like that. Let's see how this works out. And yeah, that'll work. Awesome. Right. Everything's nice and flat. Okay, let's dry that then.
It's a style.
Yeah, I see some. I think I need a little patch here. Just a smidgen. Like that. Because it kind of just ends in the middle of nowhere. The purple. There. That makes me happy. That's not too bad.
Yep, I'm done the apple, it's last thing. Back to front we work. Just want to give this a little bit of a drying so I don't mess anything up. Thanks, Dean. Fun. This would be really fun.
Doing it in a class. Okay, I'm going to cut these off so that it looks better for me. I like things neat. There. Okay, is anyone still working on the collage tablecloth or background? Thanks for coming, Teresa. Have a good nap. Catch up. I'm on the app. You're on, oh my gosh. Jeepers. All right, now. Look at you, Kimberly.
Now you want to get all your greens together for the apple.
Working mentally on a project, does that count? Sure. Absolutely, Deb. So the same process for the apples, working back to front. So for your contours of the apple, you want to be finding or cutting kind of half crescent moons. And we'll start on the back. So you have to look at your shading that you have on your apple and find papers. Again, you have to look at what kind of shades of green you have and use those papers. So this is a really, could use this for the mid-tone to the back. I might need, I don't know if I got that dark of a, I might need to possibly use black. I don't know if I have a dark enough green here. Okay, this is the darkest one I have, so I might have to just go with this and work up. So this is going to be my mid-tone. So right in here, I think because this would be the darkest, I might even use some of this. It's hard to say. Or I might cheat and just color it after it's done. That's an option too. Okay, so half crescent moons, she says. Or that gives you the direction of the apple too when you do it that way. It's kind of like painting when you paint in the direction the apples would be going, which is this way with a curve. So you do the same with paper. Long crescent shapes. Are we cutting or tearing? Always tearing. She never cuts anything. That's what she says. Don't cut with scissors. Always tear. So I'll do it her way first. And then if I want to do another one, I may change things. Hey, Vaughn, that's all right. You can always watch the recording. I need more matte medium. Yeah, I can take some of this into that there because it's got a bit of yellow on it. So you start always from, she says, the back to the front. So that's what I'm going to do. I don't think so, Kim, but it's your, you want to elaborate, I can't talk. Do something else to it. It's yours. You can experiment with it. That's how you learn. You take bits and pieces of people's ideas and you change them up. There's nothing wrong with that. Elaborate. I think that's it. Is it getting too much of a glare? I should put it up for you. Just noticed that. Let me put something in there. Put in there. Round piece of tubing. Let's do this. That better? Can see it better? All right. Although it's glary for me, but oh well. So as we get closer to your lighter parts, you kind of have to find some lighter areas, but you have to work around the apple. Okay, so these are really bright green. Let's see what we can find in bright green. That one would work. And finding some bright green. There's a nice bright thing. Yellow. That could actually go in there, too. So again, the same thing. Crescent moons around the edge. I'll make that a little bit curvier for the apple side. Like that, maybe. There we go. Thanks, Vaughn. It's fun. I like doing it. A little piece right in here. Right there, probably. Bring it down a bit. I'm gonna have to piece this one, I think. Yeah. I'll take the tip off of that. Pull it out more. There. Well, I can put a and then the white go in there. And this, I'm going to highlight there. And let's see. And I just have a little piece of white paper with some yellow on it. Just a smidgen. Which can go like that. So it gives it more. And I think I need a little bit more white in that area too. Just a smidge. Maybe thinner. That. I don't understand why paint picture and cover it up. It's so you have a base coat of where you're to put the painted papers. It's just kind of like a mat for you, so you know where to put stuff. Okay, I'm going to say this once, what I won't do for you guys. Cass is getting it's to give you the look of collage. If you, you know, it's just the different look for whatever you've painted. That patchy, I don't know, collage-y look. And it costs no sense to put my stick. Oh, God, you don't do that, Shauna. If you got vertigo and you're going to climb, girl, you don't do that. That's dangerous. I need that off. And that's too, that would go better there. Better here. No, I don't like it there. Don't like it there too much. Maybe there. Yeah. Yellowy. Hi, Cassie and Sean. Okay, this down here, like that. And make this. Trying to find bits and pieces of green and yellow. All right, it's coming, it's getting there. Still making the crescent shapes. Let's get into some of these. Probably Colleen's finished. Miss Natural Collage Artist there. I need a little bit of darker green. Just a smidge. Like that. That one. Yeah. You did. Can't wait to see everyone's work. It's going to be cool. Not too much. Oh, it's not bad. It'll do.
Wow, got a lot of green.
Papers. I guess I'll be doing more of these to use all this paper up. My God. That. And then let's put this one down. I need that medium. Here. It's turning out all right. Now I can get back into this and make the, as you get into the center of your apple, you can start doing more rounder pieces where your main focal point will be. Almost done, my apple. I just have to do the leaves. Let's see. That is. And I have to do that little piece here. And that was one I didn't have. I'm going to just try this, see what happens. It might not look great. I don't know. We'll see. Might be kind of cool for the stem, though. I don't know. We'll see. See how it looks glued down. Because it's translucent, so it might work. I don't want that big a piece, though. Has to be fairly straight. No, I don't think so. I don't like it. It's too dark. Shows up too much. Now can I get it off? Yep. I'm probably going to have to paint color over it. So I'm just going to lay a piece of collage down and then I'll do a glaze over top of that area. Hey, Chloe. You wondering what I'm doing? Feeling abandoned? There. All right, so leaves. Find my book. So you basically make little sections, leaving a space for the veins as the under tone. So I want a different kind of paper. Let's do this one. That one and a little bit of, that's too similar. Let's see. Or, no, I've got too much white. What else do we have here? We can use this one here for the lighter areas. So on this part, again, we'll be taking areas. And folding. Like so. Like that. Or like that. Like that. Okay, how did I have that? Right like that. Trim that a little bit. So there's one. So I leave an area where I painted the can't speak. Too into it. The leaves. How I can use that there. Yes, that will work there. It's a nice curve. Now I need to That's like that. Then this one needs to be like that. Okay, I think that will work there. In the darker areas, we will put some of this. Let's see here. Like so, and then, oh, this is a tricky one. I have to go around the apple. Let's see. Good enough. Good enough. And another piece. I must have bits and pieces here that I can use. This one does. That one. Wow. Sure wouldn't want to do one of these small pieces, that's for sure. Especially when you got sticky fingers. Okay, that there. These. How's everyone doing? Anyone giving up yet? Never give up. smidgen for the top. Let's see what I can find here. Maybe. Just a tiny little bit. No, that doesn't look right. That doesn't look right. There. That's good enough. All right, then, you know what? I didn't do any brown. Oh, that's crazy. No, let's see what I can find. I'll use some of this. It doesn't have to be a big piece. I might have to piece things. Yeah. Oh, I know what I can use. That piece that I was... This. I'll use this. Where did I put that piece? Now. I'll never find it now. Maybe there's another one. Giraffe. Darn, where did I put that? That would have been perfect. Let me find another one. I gotta glaze it. I haven't got a brown one, so I'm going to just stick on some. Something with a line on it and then glaze over top of it. So let's see. Let's see what, well, maybe I could use this. Draw. Let's see what I can do. That. And then can do that and then use some glazing. That's what I'm going to do. Like that. And then a light color on top. Kind of a half a circle. So if I do that on there, I have to make it smaller. All right. I think I need to put some darker in there just to hide that so I can see the stem clear. Where's that? The stem. That's the stem. Now, I might have to outline that. Might be doing some different stuff too. All right. Then let it dry. Cut all your edges. No, she doesn't do any kind of pen work, but so let's dry it.
I quote, need to make painting papers, not liking paper. Okay. I just found that you have to find what your subject is going to be. Wait till I finish drying this and I'll talk to you.
Okay, it's not tacking up. Yeah, CB, what I find, now I know she probably doesn't do this all the time because she has a ton of paper, but if you've got an idea what you're going to do and you paint it out or you're using a photograph, then make up your papers to that project. And that way you're not spending days, if not weeks, trying to find certain papers for certain things, because you'd have to be ruffling through all kinds of papers to find one little piece. So if you have it all made out ahead of time, it would go a lot quicker. That's what I find. During her last retreat, she did Facebook Live and critiqued Stu. Oh, cool. I'll have to, I haven't gone on her site for quite a while. Like, I imagine, you know, you would have it all put in certain drawers or whatever you're going to store your papers in by color, and then use that if you're not in a, you know, if you don't mind taking your time. But I probably wouldn't, starting out, I probably wouldn't do it that way, because I think you'd get frustrated if you were a student and had to ruffle through papers to find certain colors. I think to start off, I think you should make your own painted papers. Mind you, you don't have to make as many as I did. But it's nice to have different textures and different color, like shades of one color and maybe some patterns, different patterns in each color. Sort of papers by, yeah. But, well, you don't have to do as much pasting of little pieces as you cut out large areas where it'd be a little easier for you to find what you wanted in your papers. But yeah, I like this, and I definitely will do it again. I think what I'll do is, I got some lifting up, didn't glue. Like for this area here, I think all you have to do is get some brown. Let's see, I think I have some brown in here somewhere. Use some brown, and if you find your shading isn't exactly the way, just put a coat of glaze over top of it. So this is raw umber, and I'll just use my old paintbrush here. So I better use my other one. This one's flared too much. Where did I put that? There it is. My other brush. So I'll just put, because I want this darker, because you can't distinguish this from the other. And just add a little bit of color to it. If it's light enough, your pattern paper will still shine through. Same with the, let's put a little bit of green on the bottom here. Mix a little bit of brown in it. Darken up the green. And you could go along the bottom and shade that up. Just use a little bit of matte medium to blend it out. You never know the difference. Same with here. Sure. A little darker in the center. Kathy looks. Thanks, Kathy. I have a friend that uses magazine images. Yeah, I've seen people use that. I think that's amazing. Oh, well, it's recorded. I don't know what time it is there for you, Lena. Would be normal markers and her fingers. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, you could use the Tombow markers or whatever. But see, you can just add a little bit of, now I can put, again, some a little bit of highlight in. Say on the top here. So a little bit of brown and that's not white. Silly. Put some white out. I got papers hanging off of me. And just put a little highlight it a little bit so it sticks out from the, that's all you need, little bits. The same with that down here. Realistically, those colors would be shadowed. So let's put a little bit of purple in the shadow areas just to cover this. Give a little tinge of purple. There. Or you can just leave it. It's whatever you like to do. There. I'm done. I think it turned out cool. I'm pleased with it. It didn't take as long as I thought it would, which is good.
You definitely have to play with it. And each time you do something, you'll learn something new. So the main thing is get doing it. The paper, I would start off doing on manila file folders. Yeah, it all depends on what you like, button. Different. It gives it a different look. Yes, exactly, Susie. I was saying that earlier, that this reminds me of doing mosaic glass. We used to do tabletops and countertops for people. Take weeks to do, whereas this only takes a small amount of time. Oh gosh, I'm sorry, Sean. Am I overlapping on you? Jeez, I didn't realize what time it was. Okay, guys, thanks for coming. Go to Sean's. And thanks for all being here. And, I'm going to try and stream a little more often. I haven't got a definite day yet. I might come on Thursdays at 1 because until Jean's ready to, or maybe she doesn't want to come back on Thursdays anymore. I don't know. But whenever she wants, I'll find another spot and she can come back on Thursdays. If that's all right with Jean. Because Thursdays, I'm usually home, unless I get storm stayed and out of town. But I'd let you know. So if that works with everybody, that's what I'll do. So I want to get back into the streaming. It makes me sit down and create something because I tend to procrastinate. So
So thanks, guys. And I'll get cleaned up and go over to see Shauna. So you guys have a good day.